Fight number 10. Let's get our fighters into the octagon. First of all, in the red corner, from Maasai, ground and pound, Ali Arish.
From Maasai ground and pound, we have Ali Arish going down to the cage. Now, I refereed his first pro fight a couple of weeks, well, about a month ago, over in Bradford. Showed some good skills. The guy's an excellent wrestler. He's got some really good, some Iranian wrestling skills. He's actually got some semi-pro fights. He's got some good semi-pro experience. Been three fights and a draw at semi-pro. So he's actually unbeaten as and he really is. What I thought watching the fight, as I was refereeing, he was good, he's got some decent wrestling, and if he could just, and it's not bad stand-up either, if he could just put it together and work his tricep, be a bit more active on the ground, I think he could make a top fighter.
I think you're right, I think he's certainly got all the tools. You mentioned there he's got the Iranian background. Anybody who knows Iranians will know that wrestling is huge in that country. Iranian wrestlers always dominate international competitions. Very, very strong wrestling background. He's a tough guy. His weight cutting's perfect thanks to the wrestling. He comes in very strong, very heavy. His fitness is without question. He packs quite a hard right hand. He's certainly got the package to cause people problems.
And his opponent tonight, he fights in the blue corner, from Antonio's gym in London, Marius Buzanas.
A lot of boos there from, I've actually not heard one of Antonio's gym getting booed as much tonight as this guy is.
Yeah, I don't know what I saw. Maybe the guys are just having a bit more fear in them now.
Quite possibly, or, you know, the lads have been putting up tough fights out of Antonio's gym, and I wonder if, like, the hometown crowd are a little bit fearful that their guy's in for another spell in the grinder.
I think you make a very good point. I think, to start with, they're looking at their fighters and thinking, yeah, we've got to win here, and they're getting behind them. Now I think, oh, no, these guys are actually here to fight. You know, they're a tough team of guys.
This is Marius Buzynkas. He comes in with a record of 4-4-1. So on paper, he's more experienced. Although half that experience is losses.
He ran down there, dubbing a punch at Ali Arish. Ali didn't even bother moving. He didn't even flinch. Just laughed to himself.
A little smile from Ali there. Ali's not fazed by that kind of thing.
When these introduce our fighters one more time. In the red corner, fighting out of Moss Side, round and pound, Ali Arish. And his opponent tonight fights in the blue corner, from Antonio's gym in London, Marius Buzynkas. This is a welterweight fight over three fighting rounds.
Buzynkas certainly isn't short of confidence, is he?
Yeah, certainly. I mean, he's just around. I mean, I don't know whether it's bravado or whether he just loves to get in that cage.
Well, we'll find out in about 10 seconds.
Yeah, there's certainly one thing, you can't hide that. And look for Ali, he's got a nice upright sort of Eastern European boxing style. He'll come out and sort of throw shots, but I think look for him to be getting a shoot in a top position. That's what I think he'll be wanting to be. Especially against Antonio's guys, who've got fairly decent striking.
And there's a good shot
at that ankle
smiling.
Pick. Ankle pick and some aggressive punches. He turns over, he finishes those shoots so well.
Ferocious takedown.
Yeah, his takedown's brilliant. He fires some shots in there. and they got stood back up, and he just fires in for another takedown, turns the corner, straight on his back. He's, that wrestling is just second to none.
Excellent.
He's working for the key lock already. I think another thing with wrestling skill like that is it makes you much more
look,
comfortable.
Look, he's got that slowly got it, and look for him to rag this now. He's going to rag this on. Referee needs to be raised for that tap. He's got a good base, good position. And
is it possible for Pazinkas to get out of this now?
Nothing's impossible, but I think he's in a bad position.
That's a real bad... That arm's getting bent at an angle
tight,
now.
Yeah, and it's tight. And he's going to struggle to straighten the arm out. Struggle to any escapes. He'll struggle to sweep him because of Ali's got a very strong base. I think Ali just needs to stick with it. Maybe, yeah, or possibly even get the leg over the head and just rag this submission on.
Again, I'm very impressed with this guy from Ansel Hills too. I mean, these guys take a fight on late notice, they're fighting out of town, they've got no friends or family here. You could easily just turn up, take the money and go home.
Oh yeah, they certainly don't do that. That's one thing, I think, they definitely earn their money, they are tough guys.
Bazinka's now gritting his teeth in pain, he's not enjoying himself one bit.
No, he's not. And this submission's on, I mean, this is a fight-ending submission. He needs to get it out a little bit away from the body, maybe put his knee underneath the back of the head. But it's, I mean, this is definitely a fight-stopping submission.
I'm amazed he's held on as long as he has. For people that are watching this, maybe don't know jiu-jitsu, don't know what a key lock is, this puts pressure on the shoulder, it dislocates the shoulder, it really stretches the tendons to breaking point. If the submission is carried right through, the shoulder turns full circle and rips out the socket. Very, very painful.
Certainly, and it also pops all right around the elbow joint as well. You get a lot of strain around the elbow joint because it puts such a tight position on the elbow. I've had it popped over my elbow and it's horrible. Now, he's done very, very well.
Very, very well. Very impressive.
And that just shows you one thing. He is not going to quit. He's not going to quit.
Oh, lovely. Unsuccessful.
Yeah. Nice flamboyant technique, but Ali dropped his level straight underneath it and he's got the top position again.
You see, if you take your foot off the floor against the wrestler, you've got to prepare to be taken down. Pretty dangerous kicking against the wrestler.
Certainly, I believe so. Even throwing the low kicks, you can get your ankle caught and end up being taken down. Now, I think Ali is going to start to look for some more strikes here from the top position rather than going straight away for a submission, because it didn't really do him that much good going straight for the submission. I think he needs to wear him down, dishearten him with some heavy strikes.
And one thing you see now with Ali's wrestling experience compared to earlier in the night when we were talking about, say, Alex Manoa, you see how Ali's, he's not rushing, he's sitting his hips down, his base is there, he's in no danger of getting swept. That's the experience showing through in the wrestling background.
Certainly, but the one thing, I mean, one criticism I would make of him from when I refereed his last fight is I did have to stand him up a fair few times from mount position, and I don't like to stand up someone from such... Oh, he's going for a submission.
Pazinkas is going for the armbar.
Unfortunately, the cage is in the ring.
Arishin playing a novel defence with the side of the foot there.
Yeah.
Now Pazinkas needs to separate the hands.
Ali has to separate the hands.
Can he throw kick?
He cannot kick from the floor. He cannot kick from the floor there. Now, the referee there is playing advantage there, what the referee's doing. The referee could stand up. That's a knee to the head. That should be a disqualification.
Oh, he's been told now.
Again, as I say, he's playing advantage. If he stands him up, that would go in the favour of Zarimkis. So. Okay, and they stood back up. Now, certainly there. Those kicks there and his head could have had an effect there on Ali. I don't think they have done, but it's unfortunate that he's using that technique. But it's difficult for a referee there in that position when someone's in an armbar to do anything about it. You don't want to immediately DQ them. So you give him the warning, warn him again. It's not really had that much effect, I don't think, because he wasn't in a position where he could really have finished it against the cage.
True, true.
So some good refereeing there. This is better for Ali. This is what I like to see. Firing some more shots in, it's still working. I think there's definitely been a massive improvement this fight to how there was to when I refereed him and how I stopped him, because he was sort of getting to top position but not doing much with it. Here, he's certainly firing the strikes in. He's attacked for submissions. And I think there's a massive improvement over the